Here we go, guys.
Okay, guys. So here's our introduction. My name's Paul Brown. This is my lesson two reading lesson with my two students. I have Abraham Vega and Jorge Munoz. My hope is still on Nirpan. And we're going to do our reading lesson through Nirpan. It's a lesson on ethics. Do you guys know what ethics are? Ethics? Never heard of ethics? We're going to try to figure out what ethics are. First of all, can you think of somebody in your life that you admire? Somebody that you're like, wow, that's a good person. I really want to be that person. Why Mr. Beast? What's something you admire about Mr. Beast?
Because he has a lot of people on it. I think that he donated
$10,000
to charity.
Ooh, that's very good. Donation to charity. You guys should be writing this down just as I am, okay? Charity is what you give to, like, an organization that helps people to better their lives. A lot of times people give money to certain charities that help feed people, that help give people housing, that help give people clothes, all kinds of stuff that charity does. So that's a good thing. That's something admirable. It's something that shows that that's a good person, that they're donating to charity. What else? Jorge, do you have someone that you could think of that you're like, wow, that's a really great person. They do a lot of great stuff. Can you think of somebody like that? Maybe somebody that gives you a lot of food. Maybe somebody that gives you prizes. What qualities do you see? Might have to do with donations, maybe giving something, maybe somebody that... Maybe mom, dad, aunt, cousin, somebody that does good stuff. Your cousin, what does your cousin do? So she gave him some money. So maybe gives money to the homeless? Something like that? We're going to say that part, because that sounds a little bit like what you're describing. He has money to homeless. So that's a good quality, wouldn't you say? Somebody donates to charity to help people who are less fortunate to them. Somebody who gives money to people, random people they see on the street to try to make sure that they have a better life. Maybe they have some food. Maybe they have a place to go. This shows a morale. When you have good ethics, Mara asked you what ethics were at the beginning. This shows when somebody does something like this, it means no one's around, no one can see that this person gave money to charity. No one can see when you're randomly walking down the street and you see somebody and say, oh, you need some money for food here. Here, man, here's $20. Go get you some food. That shows someone cares about the general public. That shows they have good ethics. That in the time when no one else is looking, they're going to do the right thing. not do this kind of stuff. Okay? Understood? So ethics is people who do good things when no one else is looking. It shows they do the right thing no matter what. Okay? So we're going to talk about school and a subject that you guys have probably come across many times. Once you guys are done, hit submit on those. Moral principles that help guide a person's behavior. What are moral principles for him? Moral principles. Guiding to do the right thing, yes. It's your own personal person inside of you that guides you to do the right thing and makes you have good behavior, even though no one else is looking. So we're going to read about cheating in schools, on tests. Have you guys ever seen anybody cheat on a test?
Yeah,
I've heard of them. You've heard of them, me too. But do you think that's a good person? Probably not, yeah, because they're not doing the right thing when no one's looking. Because if they cheat, sometimes they can get away with it. But we're going to read about an article and see what happened to these people who decided to cheat. So Abraham, can you read our first few paragraphs here? Can you read from your screen or opposite? Start at the beginning. Angelo Angelis. Yep, right there. Angelo Angelis, a professor.
Recently grading.
technology.
Percent.
Admitted.
Admitted.
To
the
cost.
Yeah.
numbing. Consistencies. Inconsistencies, not the same. Like if I say, oh, you always get an A on your spelling test, and that shows you have consistency to always get an A on your spelling test. It means something that happens over and over and over and over. You can always tell. But remember, we talked about Jill. He knows he's doing something wrong. In Joe's view, he's just doing what the rest of the world is doing. So does it make it okay if the rest of the world is as bad ethics or bad morals? No, because you still have to be a good person because you're doing the right thing. That's what he's saying. Is everyone else is doing it. Why can't I? I do that a lot in this class, actually. So having good morals doesn't mean doing everything bad that everyone else is doing. You have to be the right person to step in. This is what Joe's saying. He's like, everyone else is doing it, so why can't have one. Here's Mary. She's saying, I know this is wrong. I know people shouldn't be cheating. But the system is just allowing it. There's nothing I can do about it. So she's saying, I know it's wrong. I don't want to do it. But it's such a temptation because everyone's doing it. So she's trying to figure out, am I really doing the right thing by having these ethics that show that it is bad for me to cheat? Real quick, and then we're going to answer.